wondering why everyone you see is standing along the street with a look of expectation on their faces, then you haven't heard the news. Santa Claus is coming to town, and of course that can mean only one thing. It's the Santa Claus Parade.
Since early this morning, kids of all ages have been flocking downtown. They've arrived on buses, subway, cars, even on foot, all with the hope of getting a good spot along the parade route, because this is a sight you see only once a year.
And as the parade draws nearer, you can sense the excitement and expectation in the air. After all, Santa Claus is about to arrive.
Hi, everyone. I'm Faye Dance.
And I'm John Dawe. We're delighted to be back with you again this year as the host of the 1986 Santa Claus Parade. This is the oldest annual Santa Claus Parade in Canada, indeed in all of North America. And for my money, it's the best one, too.
And this truly is a parade for all of Canada. Besides the Global Television Network, it's being carried on the French network by CFTM in Montreal and the TVA network throughout Quebec.
Bien sûr. In fact, our French-speaking counterparts are in the booth right next door, Louise Rinflette and Denis Larocque.
Hello, Faye.
Hello, John.
Bonjour, Louise et Denis.
Ça va bien?
Oui, et toi? You're not alone today.
Oh, no, we have two co-hosts. And it's Mylène and Jean-Martin that are with us.
Well, marvelous kids. We're going to have a lot of fun.
Well, bienvenue à Toronto and bienvenue à la parade du Père Noël et Joyeux Noël.
Joyeux Noël!
The parade is also being broadcast by a network of Operation Santa Claus stations, which include CKVU-TV in Vancouver, CFAC-TV in Calgary, CITV in Edmonton, CKND-TV in Winnipeg, and the ASN network in Atlantic Canada. So hello to all of you on this very special day.
Hi there. Well, do you know what the best part about doing this is, Faye?
Well, I'm not sure, but I think you're going to tell me.
The best part is that we've got the best seats in the house right here.
Well, that's true. Well, actually, we've got sort of a bird's eye view, but there is someone right down where the action is, and that's Sandy Hoyt, and he's going to be showing up from time to time during on the parade from his vantage point.
Well, as a matter of fact, Sandy is right down there now with about hundreds of thousands, or certainly thousands of excited people. So why don't we find out what's happening down there, Sandy?
Well, I'd like to have you meet some of my friends now. This is Mandy sitting next to Sandy. Up here is Leslie, ready to sing. And Brandon, my friend down here. Here's a song we all love to sing, especially at this time of the year. Lead us off, Brandon.
Oh, you better watch out. You better not cry. You better not pout. I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town.
Yes, Santa Claus is on his way, and all the kids are ready here. How about you, John and Faye?
Thanks, Sandy. It sounds like you've got some pretty dedicated fans down there.
Well, of course, at this time of the year, everyone's a Santa Claus fan. He must get more mail than all the rock stars put together.
Well, that's true, and he's certainly going to get a lot of letters today because kids have been asked to bring along their letters to Santa right to the parade route, and they have a lot of special Santa Claus letter carriers.
There you go. But if you couldn't make it to the parade and you still want to get a letter off to Santa, here's the address. Santa Claus, care of the North Pole, area code H-O-H-O-H-O, or ho-ho-ho. It's that simple.
And speaking of getting places safely, right now we'd like to go back to Sandy Hoyt because he's with someone who specializes in safety.
Well, I would like you to meet Deputy Police Chief William Kerr of the Metro Toronto Police Department. Tell me, how many people do you have out there working today in the parade?
We have 325 police officers as well as 175 auxiliary police officers.
Now, how long a day is it for them? When do they start?
Well, some of these officers started at 4 o'clock this morning.
How many people do you think will line this parade route today?
There will be, I'm sure, approximately 500,000 people lining the route.
And you know, you're here for another year. How many years has it been?
I've been involved for 27 years now in my police service.
Well, enjoy it today. It should be a fabulous parade.
Thank
John and Faye?
Well, here comes some pretty important people, the celebrity clowns.
You know, every parade needs a clown, and there's a job we'd all love to have, except these people actually pay to get the job.
In fact, Faye, each year these generous people donate $1,000 toward the continuation of the parade, and for that donation, they get the privilege of joining the parade as a celebrity clown.
I think Sandy's managed to get a personal interview with a couple of this year's clowns, so maybe we can find out who they are. Sandy?
Well, Faye, you'll see several clowns today in this parade. Upside-down clowns, of course. The Santa Claus parade is favorite, is famous for that. But here come some celebrity clowns now, and they're coming my way, and I'm not quite sure who they are. Of course, many of these clowns are anonymous, some with the green top hats and tails. They are celebrities More clowns than celebrities today. They're coming my way now, these celebrity clowns. I can spot them. But that's George Cohan. I know George Cohan. And that looks like Ron Barbaro. Well, Merry Christmas to you guys. Good to see you again. Fine.
Are you cold?
No, I'm just toasty warm. How are you clowns doing?
We're doing, what do you mean clowns? This is the way we work at this. This is it.
Did you actually choose those shoes?
I chose mine.
And Ron, I see you got a haircut for the occasion.
Well, I had a back comb. George does it for me because, you know, George has a lot of hair.
Hey, have the kids been happy to see you guys?
Wonderful. Oh, it's the greatest crowd we've seen since we've been doing this.
No kidding. It is dynamite. People. It is so thick all the way. It's fabulous. And the clowns, that's why we're so slow. There's so many people.
Any sign of Santa Claus?
Yeah, he's down the road just a bit. Just
you'll be
coming.
In a sleigh with reindeer and Rudolph for the first time this year.
He has a red costume on like the front. Like
Rudolph is here this year?
Rudolph is here.
And all of the other reindeer. Right, I hope she's here too. Terrific. John and Faye, celebrity clowns, and so much more.
Thank you, Sandy. And as Sandy said, we have George Cohan and Ron Barbaro, who are the co-chairmen of the Santa Claus Parade, as long as we also have directors Peter Labette, Peter Beresford, Ray Biggert, Norman Jewison, and Irving Ungerman. And right now, we are going to take a short break, but we will be right back with the 1986 Santa Claus Parade.
And pay close attention, because in this next message, you're going to find out all about those wonderful people who make the parade possible.
And then we'll be right back. And we are back to the 81st annual Santa Claus Parade, as promised.
And here comes a popular sight here in Toronto, the Metropolitan Toronto Police Mounted Unit.
And kids just love to come out and pet the horses as they're standing on patrol in the parks.
They sure do, aren't they? Just a terrific sight to see. They're so proud. Look at that. And following closely on the heels, or should I say the hooves, of the Mounted Police is the Metropolitan Toronto Police Pipe Band.
Terrific. They have a special reason for marching so proudly today, though, John, because 25 members of this large corps just returned from the World Championships in Glasgow, Scotland, where the pipe band placed sixth out of 35 bands in the grade 2 class, and the drum corps placed first. So congratulations on a job well done.
Boy, I'll say congratulations. And they played as well in Scotland as they're doing for us. Well, the parade, look at it. You know it's starting to roll now, because here's the color party. A tremendous display of flags, including the Canadian flag, all 10 provincial flags, Northwest Territories and the Yukon flags, Metro Toronto, and of course, the official flag of the Santa Claus Parade, La Parade du Père Noël.
And just to make sure the parade continues in true Christmas style, the flags are being carried by 35 Christmas elves.
Isn't that colorful? And they're waving to all the hundreds of thousands of people who have lined the route today. We're told it could be the biggest in history. There were 500,000 last year, Faye. And there's some celebrity clowns having some fun right out in front of the color party.
Merry Christmas!
There we go. Well, here comes a sight and sound to get the blood stirring on a crisp wintry day. It's the Queen's University's bands.
And they are certainly an impressive sight. 125 young people all decked out in traditional Highland dress and making some wonderful music for us here at the Santa Claus Parade.
Look at that.
Where would you rather be on a Sunday afternoon than right here?
Right, good for Queen's University, the bands. Lots of fun. They're going to be in Macy's. Well, here we are, the sign we've all been waiting for, the lead float of the 1986 Santa Claus Parade.
And appropriately called Season's Greetings, this float comes to us courtesy of the terrific Toys R Us people. And if there's one thing they know about, it's how to greet the season properly.
Boy, I'll say, just ask any kid. This float is filled with all the ornaments that remind you of Christmas. Bells, chimes, Christmas baubles. Look, there's Christmas ribbons and bows, and of course, poinsettias, the traditional Christmas plant.
If some of the ornaments look alive, that's because they are. There are 18 ornament girls all dressed in short red satin dresses trimmed with silver lamé and silver sequins, and they're all crowned with silver tiaras.
Well, that's the kind of magical thing that happens each year at the Santa Claus Parade, Faye. Anybody can be anything they want to be.
John, that's the first of 21 floats, all of them new except for one favorite from last year, which we'll show you later. You know which one.
Exactly. My favorite from last year. Aren't they cute? Aren't they lovely? They've been waiting for it all year, too, all those 1,200 youngsters.
You know, we were told this week it's going to be bigger, better, and brighter than ever before, and already it is.
It sure is, and season's greetings. Oh, and look at that. Following the lead float are some more magical things. They've almost come to life. They're walking poinsettias.
Well, John, they're actually young girls dressed in red eyelash dresses with gold sequin trim and poinsettia headdresses.
I guess you could say they're ringing in the Christmas season.
The Christmas ornaments keep on coming with 16 Yuletide chimes outfitted in short silver dresses trimmed with red and green and topped by bell headpieces.
And they've got bells too. Everyone's ringing in the Christmas season. Can you feel that excitement, that expectation in the crowd? I mean, look at last year, compared to last year, we're looking down at tens of thousands of people around the Ontario Legislature here on Queen's Park
That's
Crescent.
That's right, and the best weather Canada can offer. It's terrific today.
And I'm having as much fun waving at everybody.
Coming up now is the Conqueror 2 Drum and Bugle Corps, which is a relatively new band, but already they've made their mark, taking several provincial championships.
And they've been with the parade for the past 3 years. They've certainly lived up to their name. After all, they've conquered us, I'll tell you, with their good music. Listen to that. Corps Director Jim McFarland. They were only formed in 82. There's 55 of them. How do you like those gaucho hats? Aren't they smart?
I like that. Nice style.
One, two, three. Oh, now here's a group that's guaranteed to bring a little sunshine into our lives. This is the Sunbeam Princess and her 12 Sunbeam Escorts.
You'll notice the princess is wearing one of the wonderful walking skirts the parade is famous for. This one is bright yellow satin overlaid with gold and dotted with yellow chiffon. And of course, she's wearing a gold sunburst on her head.
And the escorts compliment the princess. Look at that, with more gold and yellow in their own sunburst headdresses. Oh, what a sight. Look at that.
Aw, and these little bunch of fellows in costumes, they look good enough to eat. They're all dressed up as gingerbread boys.
I guess they must have escaped from the witch's, wicked witch's house in the story Hansel and Gretel. Oh, the second float, it's here. It presents a character, he's almost as popular, or she is as Santa Claus, it's Mother Goose. Her float is called Once Upon a Rhyme. and it's presented by Canadian Tire. We'd like to thank our friends from Canadian Tire for helping to keep this parade rolling right along.
And this is a wonderful presentation of rhymes. Mother Goose, of course, is at the head of the float, and she's always makes an appearance in the parade. And there's a great big pumpkin house just passing us with an ornately decorated roof and Peter Pumpkin Eater and his wife.
Sandy, I'll bet you can find some kids down there who can help us out with some of their nursery rhymes.
Well, John, I do have three with me. I have Jonathan Dawe, you just heard from his dad. And this is Tim Beresford. And down here is Rachel Corbett. Now, Jonathan, as you look at these Mother Goose characters, can you think of some of the rhymes? Anyone
yes.
at all? Give us a recitation of a rhyme.
A rhyme,
Mary, Mary, Blake Contrary is one. We're gonna hear that from Rachel. How about Jack and Jill?
Okay, Jack and Jill went up the hill to fetch a pail of water. Jack fell down and broke his crown, and Jill came tumbling after.
Oh, boy. And what about that Mary, Mary, quite contrary we see there, Rachel?
Yeah.
What does that rhyme say? You have Mary, Mary, quite contrary. How does your garden grow?
The silver bells and cockle shells and pretty ways all in the row.
Yes, and Tim Beresford is here as well. Which one do you have for us, Tim?
Simple Simon.
Do you remember how it goes?
Simon, the pie man, going to the fair. Said Simple Simon to the pie man, let me taste your wares.
Thank you, kids, very, very much. Thank you to Jonathan and Tim and Rachel. Yep, all those rhymes come alive, don't they, John and Faye? Thanks, kids.
Well, now we're hearing from the band of the Royal Regiment of Canada, which is the oldest permanently formed band in Canada. It was started way back in 1862.
And do you know they've played for every reigning English monarch since they were formed? While we listen to the band of the Royal Regiment of Canada, we are going to take a short break right now.
But don't worry, you're not going to miss a thing. We'll be right back with the 1986 Santa Claus Parade.
Stay with us. A new float, which I know is going to be a big hit. It's called Playtime with Dolly, and we know it's going to delight children everywhere, which is no surprise since it's brought to us by the terrific people at McDonald's restaurants who know a lot about delighting children.
Boy, they sure do. All I can say is hello, Dolly.
Oh,
well, hello, Dolly.
I knew you wouldn't resist. The huge rag doll is wearing a pink ruffled blouse under a blue jumper.
Look at the size
of that dog.
Aren't
and cat.
They terrific?
By the way, I should mention that Peter Beresford's children are on the float. He is the director of the Santa Claus Parade. We have his daughters, Kate and Melissa. And Peter has contributed a lot of time and creativity to the parade over the last few years.
I want the folks at home to see that they're beginning to see something very special that's happening in the Santa Claus Parade. The characters are becoming bigger and bigger. There's 30% increase in the size of the characters this year, and you're seeing a good example of it there with Dolly and her friends.
And that means more magic, John.
It sure does. Heads are turning, acknowledging the thousands of people who've gathered to watch them. And how about that? Here comes a new band. Actually, they're not new at all. They're the Guelph Royal Airs Drum and Bugle Corps, formed back in 1932 by World War I veterans.
And obviously they learned a lot over the years because they sound sensational.
Thank you.
our court gestures. The court can't be far behind. Here's the Queen of Hearts in her luxurious red velvet walking skirt, escorted by her 12 maids, beautifully outfitted in yellow satin and gold headdresses. And of course, there's the King coming up right behind. The Knave of Hearts carrying his traditional tray of tarts and six pages all dressed in red, blue, and gold.
There must be royalty close at hand. More royalty coming up, isn't that? Look at, again, the gold against the background of that asphalt. Isn't that wonderful? And the red? Well, we've talked about magical things happening in the Santa Claus Parade and Fairyland Friends. That's our, you're seeing it now. It's a perfect example. It's brought to us by Petro-Canada, and with all their stations across the country, they know about thinking big.
And big is what this float is all about. Imagine taking a magnifying glass into Fairyland, and this is what you will see. Little gnomes having the time of their life, riding purple snails and playing with their friends.
Isn't it something? You know, this float is done pretty much to scale so that the giant orange and yellow frog that you see and all the other characters are right in size in comparison with the other characters, like those red polka-dotted mushrooms.
I'll bet Sandy can get a good close look of this float right from the street level.
Well, I have the best seat in the house. Would you have a look at this frog? Look at the size of this guy. Huge! And really, when you're this close to the float, you can appreciate the hours and the months, yes, the entire year that goes in to make the magic that is the Santa Claus Parade. There's that dragonfly balancing delicately on a fern frond at the front of the float, Faye. There's a grasshopper. Can you see the grasshopper?
Well, you know, it's
there's a grasshopper coming along here in just a moment, getting ready for a great big hop, putting on his big red running shoes. And they have real shoelaces, too. Oh.
Sandy, this is not only one of the longest floats in this parade at 43 feet, it's one of the longest in the history of the Santa Claus Parade.
But I can, once again, look at the upsizing of all of these creatures, the size of the floats. It's all to make the Santa Claus Parade that much more magical, that much more wonderful for not only the folks at home watching on television, for the tens of thousands watching on the street in what is turned into be a very nice day for a parade.
Marching, and they've been part of the parade for over 20 years, the Melbourne Collegiate Marching Band.
Well, they march and perform all over the Toronto area, and they're one of the few high school bands in Canada to wear the kilt uniform.
Well, they may have cold knees, but their playing warms our hearts.
That's the Cunningham tartan. The thing I like the most about the Santa Claus Parade is that all your favorite dreams and your favorite stories come to light. This is Storybook Land, a float full of fantasy and of fun, and of course, Mattel Canada. The people who are presenting this float know all about making children's favorites come to life.
Well, this is a magical float with some of the world's most popular stories coming to life right out of the back of the float. And Cinderella, with her horse-drawn coach, portrayed by Michelle Labette, daughter of Peter Labette, parade director. Now there is lots of color for you, John.
Boy, I'll see.
We are not disappointed.
How about that? There's Cinderella. That must be Cinderella. Hello, Michelle. So pretty.
You know, we did see, we have to confess, we have seen these floats off and on the last couple of weeks, but until you sit here and actually see them, it starts the excitement all over again.
Absolutely. In the secret warehouse, they don't look like anything compared to how they look here out on the streets.
Well, they come alive here.
They sure do. But I think we should go down to Sandy,
yes,
see what's happening.
He's the biggest kid on the street. Sandy Hoyt, where are you?
I'm right here. I am the biggest kid on the street today. Robin Hood and his merry men. Now, how many of you kids know any of these characters marching behind this float? Who are some of Robin Hood's merry men? Huh? Do you know one? You don't. Little John is one.
My Tut.
Yeah.
Anybody else? Do you know any of the merry men? There's Alan Adale, Will Scarlet. See Will Scarlet over there? He's the guy in the red. And who's that pretty girl?
Marianne.
Maid Marianne, indeed. Oh, let's go back to John and Faye now.
Thanks very much, Sandy. We're watching all the follow-up. We're going to get another band coming up shortly. I just have that feeling.
Do you realize that all the moms and dads and kids who are up early this morning for this Santa Claus parade and...
There we go, as promised. This band is sponsored by the city of Brantford, Ontario. It's the St. John's Drum and Bugle Corps. And it used to be the oldest all-girls drum corps until it went co-ed just last year, which is a smart thing to do.
Well, they look terrific in their military-style uniforms, and they sound terrific, too.
Well, there's a lot more to come, more colorful floats, more of all the excitement for the Santa Claus Parade.
And don't forget Santa Claus. He definitely is coming to town today.
So don't go away. We'll be right back with the 1986 Santa Claus Parade. Well, this next float, it's based on the Hans Christian Andersen fairy tale called The Nightingale. It's about royalty, and it's brought to us by royalty, our friends at Speedy Muffler King. Now, this story is about a Chinese emperor who tries to replace his prized nightingale with a mechanical bird that sings almost as beautifully. Just listen.
And there at the back of the float is the emperor in a long white robe standing behind the real nightingale and the mechanical bird. As the story goes, John, after the mechanical bird breaks down and stops singing, the real nightingale returns to the ill emperor and saves his life by singing to him.
Boy, look at that scary dragon. Oh, my goodness, look at the size of him. But the color is magnificent. There's the emperor. Isn't that a beautiful float?
This float is decorated with traditional Chinese designs and colors.
And in keeping with that theme, of course, we have a parade of girls with fans and umbrellas wearing colorful hats. And there's an interesting band. Do you know, this is the first year that this band has been in the parade. It's the Philippine Heritage Band. Their uniforms are based on traditional Philippine dress. Isn't that exciting? Look at those outfits. Oh, how about this spectacular sight? This is Ping Ping the Panda. And it's only fitting that it should come to us courtesy of the province of Ontario. You know why, because it was in Ontario that Panda Mania hit its height with the visit of the two pandas to the Metro Zoo. Remember that, Faye?
I certainly do remember. Now I'm sure people all across Canada are going to be just as enthusiastic about this new giant panda. And by the way, a co-chairman of the parade, Ron Barbro, was responsible for bringing the two Chinese pandas over here last year. And we are now pleased to announce that Chuan Chuan has just become a father. Now, is that good
for
news?
Him. With all that good Toronto food and weather, I'm sure. Look at his head move. What a sight. He stands at least almost 13 feet tall.
In fact, the maximum is 13 and a half feet high. And the floats this year are 25 to 30% larger than last year.
Pandamania continues here in Canada. Well, that music we're here listening to now, that's the Emerald Knights Drum and Bugle Corps, and they're made up of young people from Erin Mills, Mississauga.
And along with the music, they put on a fantastic show of colors with a corps of color guards displaying the flags.
They only formed back in 1980. They're about 50. This is their fifth year in the parade.
Yes, Dance, and they are sponsored by the Mississauga Arts Council. Do you know, John, since 1905, not a single year has gone by without there being a Santa Claus parade.
And this is number 81, and it just keeps on growing. Here's a wonderful float. What's that old saying, Faye? When the cat's away, the mice will play? That's the theme of this float, The Adventures of the Musical Mice, and we have the people at General Mills of Canada to thank for it.
Well, that name is music to kids' ears when they hear What's for Breakfast in the Morning. On this float, the mice are making music with all kinds of instruments, from conga drums to giant trumpets.
Look at these guys. They've discovered a new way to play the fiddle, and it's also a teeter-totter at the same time. And there's one at the back conducting a symphony. Look at that. And you'll look at, can you read those notes?
Yes.
You see that? I'll bet those notes spell out musically three blind mice. Any musician would know that. Isn't that a remote? Look at that.
Here he comes.
Isn't that clever?
Would you call them musicians? John?
Well, either that or maestros.
Well, it looks like there are a couple of mice who decided to play with something other than musical instruments while the cat's away, and somehow they even managed to find some mouse-sized go-karts.
I think someone like Sandy should check and see if those mice have driver's licenses. What do you think?
Okay, I will check on that, John, right now, because I see one of the mice coming along in a go-kart. I'll see if I can perhaps stop him or her for just a moment and ask that question. Hi, mice. Nice to see mice, especially at this time of the year. Sorry, I forgot the cheese. Actually, I did forget the cheese. Could you come over here just a moment? Hi, just turn around this way. Okay, here he comes. I'll all right.
Watch out, Sandy.
Whoa! Hi there. What's your name?
My name's Mickey Mouse.
Hi, Mickey. How are you? And who is this?
Mike.
How are you doing, Mike?
Great.
Hey, listen, do you fellas have driver's licenses? Oh, where does a mouse get a driver's license? Good answer. I'll accept that. Have a good day. Faye and John.
Thanks, Sandy. Look at what we're seeing now. How about that?
Well, before Santa appears, there's still a whole lot of his friends who want to join the celebration.
Well, look, while we're enjoying the wonderful sounds of the 48th Highlanders Military Band, we're going to take a short break.
We have Percy the Pelican, who flew in specially to be here with a little help from Baskin-Robbins, of course.
Boy, I'll bet Percy would give up that beakful of fish he's got for a few scoops of their ice cream, such as pralines and cream, my favorite.
Just happened to slip in your favorite? Well, I know I would.
Don't those fish look real? They look like they're enjoying it out there in Percy's beak.
Well, I think they are.
Look at those wings. There he is. We're in for a whole marine land look at things coming up here now, Faye. Look at that great little hat on Percy's head there.
And you know, no one's disappointed. As you mentioned, 500,000 people watching along the parade route and literally millions more watching on TV.
Well, you know, having our friends from the French Network here with us is becoming a tradition for the Santa Claus Parade. And what's also a tradition is the inclusion of some floats which represent stories and fairy tales in the Francophone children's fantasy world. This float, La Sirène de Percé, is presented by Dominion Securities. Now, they know a good investment when they see it. and they've invested in some great fun with the Santa Claus Parade. It's a wonderful example of how the addition of Francophone culture can bring so much color and charm to the parade.
The story is about a fisherman who catches a mermaid and attempts to take her back to shore. A terrible storm comes up, and the only way to calm the waters is to throw her back. The fisherman does and sails home to tell his grandchildren of the adventure.
And the charming part about it, Faye, is that one of the grandchildren grows up to be a fisherman, has the same experience with the mermaid, returns to tell his grandchildren, so the story continues generation to generation. La sirène de Percé. It literally means the mermaid of Perpetuse, which is that wonderful rock in Gaspésie. And look at the size of that. Sure to be a winner this year. La Sirène de Percé. My goodness, we've moved from the coast. It looks like we're moving inland. Are my eyes deceiving me, Faye, or do I see? We've moved right inland. Look at that. This float is called Big Tex and his Wild West Pals. And of course, whether you're a Westerner or an Easterner, you know the people who are presenting this float, Shoppers Drug Mart, because they are as big as the prairie is wide.
Well, this float shows a sense of humor of its creator, Alf Yannarelli, parade manager. You can see Big Tex is riding the wild bull, and each time the bull kicks, he hits a teetering rock where two coyotes have been resting. You'll notice one of them is struggling to keep the other from falling off the rock, while the third looks on as though he's sleeping through the whole thing.
Isn't that something? I mean, that is very, very clever, tying in the whole vista of the float.
Very realistic.
The movement, the animation. Animation is just super. And again, the color. Even the black and white with the orange there looks wonderful, doesn't it? Poor old Tex.
I hope he doesn't fall off until he...
Not just yet,
during
anyway.
During these 6.5 kilometers.
He's allowed to in a little while. Oh, now that fella needs help. Look at that. That's very tenuous there. Oops. He gets a headache, he can always go to Shoppers for an aspirin or the like. There we go.
Doesn't that make a November sky glow with excitement with all that color and orange?
I can see this is going to be the favorite of an awful lot of viewers. Well, now here's a band that's made a tradition of playing in the Santa Claus Parade for the last 6 years, the Kiwanis Cavaliers of Kitchener Drum and Bugle Corps.
One thing that isn't traditional about this band is their uniforms. Their dress is very modern. In fact, it's almost Miami Vice style, so they add a different flavor to our parade and some tremendous music.
Take another short break now, but we'll be back with more of the Santa Claus Parade.
Right, so don't go away.
Are you kidding? Who? The best is yet to come. Well, let me tell you, everybody at the Santa Claus Parade thinks big. And if you didn't have any doubts about that, here's proof. This is Eloise the Elephant, and we have Black's Cameras to thank for this wonderful float. Eloise.
And I'll bet they'll be developing a lot of pictures from today's parade.
Can you believe that color, Faye, that beautiful pink?
She's just another example of the kind of float that seems to move all by itself magically.
It is magic. That is the magic of the Santa Claus Parade. She's going to lift her trunk in a moment now. Just you watch now. She can lift that. And she can even trumpet when she has a mind for it.
She's a very popular circus elephant. She has 12 more circus girls following her, all dressed in hot pink skirts. She's pretty tame, though, John.
Boy, I don't know. She looks tame. I mean, look at those sparkles. Oh!
And they've got circus whips, and I don't think, but they won't need them for Eloise.
Look at those
she
eyes.
Cooperates.
There she is, Eloise. Sparkling eyes of Eloise the elephant. And I would say she's about the same size as Ping Ping was.
Yes.
But it's that self-animation that's so wonderful.
There's an idea of the size. When we look down, I mean, she looks a bit smaller, but when you're on her level, she's huge.
I wish she could wink. I would like her to come by because I would love to wink at her.
You flirt.
It's okay, it's Sunday morning. Now, is she popular? Look at that. Talk about fun. Those are the meeters and greeters going along, just getting everybody so fired up. Oh, listen.
I can actually hear the elephant.
She's calling to me, Faye. I told you.
You know, this is considered to be one of the best, most beautiful, longest-running parade anywhere in the world, and you can see why. We've got color and kids and Christmas, and they all go together.
Eloise is talking to me. Well, now, we were talking earlier about tame, but that's not a word I'd use to describe this group of merry music makers. They're the Variety Village Band. They represent an exciting breakthrough.
They are the only band of their kind, and what makes them unique is that they have a color guard entirely made up of wheelchair-bound teenagers, and we are really pleased to have them entertaining us this year at the Santa Claus Parade. They were formed in 1984 by the Variety Club of Ontario.
Isn't that terrific? And what a job the Variety Club does right around the world. And I'll bet Rick Hansen's watching today and how proud he's going to be to see those youngsters participating right here in the parade.
As young as 10 years old, right up to 25.
Good for 1028. Well, here come some pretty rare birds. You only see them once a year, just about this time, Faye.
And for you avid bird watchers, they're called walking birds, and they wear pink satin dresses trimmed with turquoise checkerboard lamé, and their heads are topped with tall checkerboard headdresses.
And look, a lot of clowns around all of a sudden. That can only mean one thing to me. There's a circus coming to town. I'll bet you.
I think you're onto something, John.
Aren't those birds something? Here, well, I knew we were, it was gonna happen. This is called Under the Big Top, and it's brought to us by the people at Willy Wonderful. Wanna thank them for making the parade more wonderful through their support.
You know, George Cash and his Jolly Jesters have been with the parade for 30 years now, but I don't think he's ever been accompanied by such a huge clown as you could just see.
Isn't he? Listen to that music. Isn't...
Look how big that clown is. His whole band is able to stand on top of him.
On his tummy, would you believe? He obviously hasn't eaten yet. Look at the color. George Cash, I'll tell you, he's been involved in the parade for 32 years.
He's also the Grand Marshal of the 1987 Variety Club Bike-A-Thon. John, one more thing. This is the only band who play nonstop from beginning to the end of the parade. A lot of energy.
A boy, I'll say. And of course, they look at the nice ride they've got there.
All you can see are big feet from this end of the float.
Hear that music. Well, there's one thing you can't have too many of, and that's clowns. And the Santa Claus Parade is one place that really believes it. Look at this, Faye, clowns of every color imaginable.
And some you don't even imagine, and of course, dozens of the most popular clowns, the ones that travel the full length of the parade on their hands.
Yeah, they were created here, you know. Look at that. They were created about 25 years ago, right here in Toronto for the Santa Claus Parade, and they're a world beater.
The name of this band approaching couldn't be more appropriate. They're called the Ambassadors of Newmarket Drum and Bugle Corps. And as ambassadors, they've traveled across North America playing their music and winning championships from one coast to the other. Let's listen to these musical ambassadors. The most exciting parts of the circus is when the animals perform tricks, and that's what this float, Performing Animals, brings to life. And when it comes to bringing the color of the parade to life, Kodak Canada, which sponsors this float, is the official film of the Santa Claus Parade.
Now look, you gotta see this character. I couldn't believe it when I saw it at the Secret Warehouse. This monkey is riding a tricycle in a circle, and he's chasing after a banana that's tied to his tail.
And the seal is balancing at the front of the float.
And the tiger, you can, not quite, well, we're going to see the tiger in just a second. He's going to be jumping through the hoop. Look at that man just spending the whole day. There goes the tiger through the hoop.
Dozens of clowns dressed in a variety of brightly colored clown suits.
Gosh, that's exciting. Performing Animals. Can you imagine spending the whole parade chasing a banana that's tied to your tail and you never get it? Come on up here, monkey. I've got a banana for you.
Coming up next is the concert band of Coburg, and I must say that Coburg has a lot to be proud of. They are an impressive sight in their red and black military-style uniforms, and the music they are making is definitely music to our ears.
And you know, they entertain hundreds of people every summer with concerts in the band shell in Coburg's Victoria Park. I'm sure pleased, we're roughly pleased to have them as part of today's festivities.
They were formed in 1921. But you know, the Santa Claus Parade is for all ages, John.
It sure is.
Love angels, oh come, let us adore him.
Isn't that a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful tune?
Marching in the parade with costumes on, and you add that to the people in the band, that means we have 2,600 people involved in today's Santa Claus Parade. They deserve a lot of credit for all of this coordination. 20 floats, 21 bands, a mammoth undertaking.
And the weather today is complimenting their efforts. Thank you, Coburg. Well, now, here are some ladies. Now, hang on. Look at that. They've got the calendars all mixed up.
Wrong season.
This isn't Halloween. Why else would a group of witches travel with their own portable pumpkin?
Well, I guess it's just a reminder of the fall season, which has just passed us by. We have the Autumn Glory Princess.
Isn't she lovely?
With her orange, gold, and green eyelash dress and traveling skirt covered with fall leaves.
Isn't she pretty? That's a long walk in that outfit, isn't it? Oh, my goodness, be still my heart. This was the one float that we all loved so much last year, and everyone wanted to see it again. La Chasse Galerie, and it's returning thanks to the Prudential Insurance Company of America, my favorite.
And I'd say that they've ensured that everyone will have happy memories of today's parade. With the appearance of this float, it's based on a French-Canadian tale about a group of lumberjacks who fear they're going to have to spend Christmas Eve in a logging camp, away from their families.
Look, let's go down to Sandy Hoyt. Sandy.
We've got some French-speaking fans down there, haven't we, Sandy?
Well, Lumberjacks, and of course, the Voyageur, and as well, the Chasse Galerie. And with me is part of the Morin family, Mr. Georges Morin and his children. Hi, what's your name?
André.
And?
Edouard.
Are you having a good time, Edouard? What is your favorite float so far in this big parade? Which one did you like best?
Elephant.
Eloise the elephant. And you?
The elephant.
So we have two elephant fans here today. Would you do something for me? Would you say Merry Christmas to all the boys and girls right across Canada? Say Merry Christmas in French for me.
Say Merry
Christmas. Joyeux Noël.
Got it, Faye?
Merci beaucoup, Sandy. Merci. Well, regular parade viewers might remember this next band. They've been with us several times in the past, and we're glad they could join us again. The Oakland Crusaders Drum and Bugle Corps.
The band was originally formed in 1910 by De La Salle Oakland's College in Toronto. In 1975, they merged with the Etobicoke Crusaders to become the Oakland Crusaders and went on to win numerous national and international titles.
But while Faye and I sing along to the music of the Oakland Crusaders, we're going to take a short break.
And don't go away. We'll be back with more excitement with the Santa Claus Parade.
Come on back.
Welcome back to the 1986 Santa Claus Parade with me, Faye Dance, and my co-hosts, John Dawe and Sandy Hoyt. John, I know what's keeping the chill in the air today. It's our next float, Old Man Winter, and it comes to us courtesy of people who understand the benefits of ice-cold things, the makers of Coca-Cola.
Just look at this. This certainly is a frosty-looking float. That's Old Man Winter blowing his icy blast our way, raising his wintry wand from time to time to bring us snow. For all those who enjoy winter sports, this fellow is a welcome sight. And of course, let's face it, Santa Claus couldn't come to town. It wouldn't be right if he didn't travel over a blanket of snow. Do you hear those geese?
I'll say, good sign of winter. We've got Northern Princesses. And obviously, Old Man Winter has done his job well and ushered in the cold weather, because in his wake are a dozen icicle girls dressed in short blue eyelash dresses and snowflake headdresses. Now, I can hear a band that's
well, look at
to
that.
John's heart. Look at this.
Faye, it's the North Toronto Collegiate Marching Band, my alma mater. My goodness, I am proud of them. Calling all you North Toronto grads, don't forget that next April 23rd to 26th is the 75th anniversary celebrations of North Toronto Collegiate.
You
so come on.
To get that in.
I couldn't wait to say that. We're going to have a great time. 75 years of tradition. So if you haven't been in touch with the school, get in touch with the school and come on. Well, another sign that winter has arrived, the Winter Princess with her 12 lovely escorts.
Here's a float that gives us a special view of what animals love to do when winter comes. It's called Winter Frolics, and it comes to us courtesy of the place that knows about giving us a tremendous view, even better than today, the CN Tower.
Well, this view is a little lower than that, Faye, but it's still tremendous. But what it shows us, frankly, is that animals are a lot like people. Some of them like to play out in the cold. These animals, look at some of them are out there skating and playing, but others prefer to spend winter inside where it's nice and warm.
Up on top of the float, a skunk and a raccoon are skating, and a fox is just putting on his skates to join them. And every so often, the bear pops up from inside the tree just to see what's going on.
Sandy, you probably have a better view of what the other animals are doing underground.
Well, down here, a chorus of oohs and ahs as children of all ages enjoy the winter frolics. There's the gopher, of course, and the bear. You see the bear getting ready to hibernate there for the winter kids? And just behind the bear, I see the squirrel is getting ready for winter as well. Of course, they store their food now for a long, long cold winter. Mouse is all set to dig into a dinner of cheese. And hey, did you see that rabbit? He's glued to his television set, watching the Santa Claus parade, of course, like everyone else today.
Of course. Well, here comes a group I'm sure can barely wait till Santa Claus gets here, just like the rest of us.
These fellas are dressed in brown bear suits, and they're having a great time.
And look, a few more winter animals are following along behind. Well, that music we're hearing now comes from one of Canada's finest marching bands, the Queen's York Ranger Corps of Drums. They're only formed in 1975. We're thrilled they could join us today. They're led, by the way, by Warrant Officer John Crawford. Well, now, we've said it before, but this is truly one of the most spectacular floats in the history of the Santa Claus Parade. Old-fashioned carolers, it's called. It's a presentation that comes to us courtesy of Carnation, and I'll bet millions of carolers have warmed themselves on their hot chocolate over the years.
You know, this is actually two floats in one. The first float is two fabulous Palomino horses who are trotting along the route, pulling the second float, an elegant sleigh that glides along on golden runners. And as you can see, it's filled with old-fashioned carolers.
It's the longest, tallest, and widest float ever seen in the Santa Claus parade. Isn't that remarkable?
And you know, Elf Yannarelli, the man behind the float, says that this is the type of float we are going to see more of in the future. So we can't argue with that. They love it down there.
Two floats in one.
Once you get people starting singing carols, it's impossible to get them to stop. So we have a dozen young carolers following along behind this magnificent float. Our next group of entertainers is actually a joint effort of two bands, the Dutch Boy Drum and Bugle Corps and the Cadets of Dutch Boy.
You know, Faye, although they number altogether 120, both groups have received numerous awards for their excellent musical performances. It's that look that captures most of the imagination.
That's so true.
You got it now?
No. Haven't had it for the last year.
You know, with all of these wintry signs you see right now, it can only mean one thing.
I know, Faye. The man of the hour is just around the corner.
And that means we'll be right back with a sensational Santa Claus parade.
Come on back. Welcome back to this spectacular 1986 Santa Claus Parade on this spectacular Sunday. Well, there's no surer way to make kids smile than the sight of this, a giant toy wagon. And this one's coming to us thanks to the people who know a lot about making kids smile, Canada's Wonderland. How about that?
This is not only a giant toy wagon, it's filled with giant toys. There's a big spinning top on a great big toy drum, some dolls and soldiers and toy bears and two huge jack-in-the-boxes.
Well, just a second now, Faye. There's actually a jack-in-the-box and the other's a Jill-in-the-box.
Excuse me.
There we are. That's Jack, and there goes Jill, or vice versa. Once again, isn't that animation magical? Now, do you think that top is going to take off like a spacecraft?
I hope not. We need it till the end of the parade. You know, the wheels of the wagon turn to give the impression that it's actually being pulled by the clowns.
Jetstar, it could take off, Faye. It could.
We've got little furry pink bears at the front with bear hoods. And
of course, that is filled with toys. What is Christmas without toys?
And soldiers. They're dressed in red and gold with West Point hats.
Well, now, here's a band that's played for its share of important occasions. They're the Governor General's Horse Guards Band, Horse Guard Band. And along with playing for royalty whenever they visit, they have state trumpeters who perform in the opening ceremonies of the Ontario Provincial Legislature, which they're marching right beside at the moment.
And more importantly, today they're playing in our parade.
Their music director is Captain Mike McGann. They were formed in the late 1800s.
That's right.
Some visitors from the North Pole, but not exactly the ones we had in mind.
Well, this is my son Jason's favorite part, the herd of playful polar bears. It's still a fun sight to see. Besides, this could be a sign that more North Pole friends are on their way.
Well, here's the best proof that Santa's nearly here. This is a float full of Santa's helpers, and if they're here, Santa has got to be close by.
And when it comes to helping Santa with his sleigh full of gifts, you won't find anyone more helpful than the people at Consumers Distributing who sponsored this float.
Well, there's the North Pole at the front of the float. Just so we know for sure, it's really Santa's workshop, of course. They're just taking a little break from all their toy making all year long.
Well, they need a break. They've got lots of helpers there anyway. Elves dressed in red and white and green. Polar bears.
Look at those candy canes. I bet all the Santa fans in the audience are getting pretty excited by now. They know that Santa can't be far away. Sandy, what's the general feeling down there at street level?
Oh, good. Nothing.
Well, I guess with all these toy makers and elves and all the rest, somebody must be coming down this way. Kids, who are you waiting for?
Santa.
Santa Claus, do you think he's on his way? Why? You've waited all this time. And he's just about here. What are you going to say to him when he gets right here? Just that? How about you?
Dusty, crusty, dust.
Oh, well, that's a good thing to say. Whether or not he understands it, that's another thing.
Well, now here comes the biggest marching band in Canada, the Burlington Team Tour Band. They've been playing for 40 years, and they're acknowledged as one of the country's best. They're even regular participants in the Rose Bowl Parade. That's how good they are.
But there's another thing that makes them special. For the past few years, they're the band, John, that has preceded Santa Claus. So let's listen and watch, because Santa's going to be here any second.
Talk about excitement, expectation.
It's a very popular band, John. They've done movies and commercials and, of course, the Santa Claus Parade. Remember, this is right across Canada on a Santa Claus operation from Halifax right to Victoria, BC. So hello to all of our friends across Canada.
On the Santa Claus Network.
Thank you.
Faye, look, there he is. This is it. The moment we've been waiting for all year. Santa Claus has come to town.
And he's looking better than ever as his sleigh glides above the rooftops of the expectant children.
And he's even got Rudolph with him this year, who came along even though it isn't foggy. How about that?
Welcome, Rudolph. Welcome, Santa. This is the day every child believes in magic and every adult becomes a child as soon as we see Santa Claus. Hi, Santa. Did you give him your list?
I sure did. Hello, Santa.
This is what everyone came to the Santa Claus parade for.
And it wasn't that long of a wait.
No, it went
certainly
very
fast. An enjoyable wait.
Lots of imagination, beautiful colors, magic.
And isn't he enjoying himself? Look at that, the thrill. The thrills that he brings millions of youngsters around the world.
Do you notice how much louder the crowd is now?
Absolutely. Talk about having fun. He just keeps the look. Hello, Santa.
He's waving right at us.
Hello there. Well, all the waiting is over. The man who puts the fun in Christmas has arrived in fine style. And now the Christmas season is officially here.
And we are going to take a short break for a special message from a very special person.
Well, it looked great from here, and I'm sure it was just as exciting down on the street. What do you think, Sandy?
Well, there's only one day better than this one, and that's the 25th day of December. What a day it's been. And from all of us here, may your ribbons never tangle, may your baubles never break, may your bells always jingle. Best of this day and every day throughout the year to come. And from all of us here in the Holly Jolly Gallery, Merry Christmas!
Thank you, Sandy, and thank you to all of your friends. It has been a great parade, bigger and better than ever before.
Thanks, Sandy. Well, you know, I've been trying to make some notes about how many of those 21 floats I thought were my favorites, right? We discussed that before we went
to
where...
And I said you could only have two favorites.
Two? Are you kidding? How can you have two favorites out of 21 of the finest, most beautiful, most colorful floats ever in the history of the parade?
I love the Panda Bear, and I like Big Tex.
Well, I can tell you, I've got here Old Man Winter, that color coming down the street, that icy blast you could feel in your bones. Old-fashioned carolers, two floats in one, giant floats with those giant Palomino horses and the 13 carolers, and of course, La Chasse Galerie. It remains one of my favorites, the only float that was repeated this year, actually.
Well, every one was good. Lots of magic, lots of color. That's the important thing.
It was, and the best thing is, while we go home with our...